questions specifically for the players, followed by questions for Coach Krusty.
Well, we can breathe.
Oh, gosh.
Man, what a defensive performance by this group. Just found a way. Obviously, scoring was tough at times, but they were so locked in and focused on defense. There in the stretch, obviously, Albany made that push and run, but we still came up with huge defensive stops. Just so proud of this group. They've worked so hard. There was clear nerves out there, and rightfully so, but the defense looked like they've been doing it together forever, and I'm so proud of that, as they know I love defense. So might be working on some offense here.
Questions for the players.
Okay. Whoa, that was a mic. Ooh. I just want to say, first and foremost, I couldn't have wanted to do this with any other team. When I came here on my visit and I met the coaching staff, I had a feeling that this was going to happen eventually because of the type of people they were. They were going to bring the best out of anyone that came into their program. And when you bring the best out of everyone on a team, there's no doubt that you can get these types of championships. And so I just want to thank Kress and the whole coaching staff, because we could not be our best without them and the confidence that they instill into us. Even when, like, offensively, it was not a great game, but every time I looked over at the bench, I saw that confidence that they had in us. And it pushed me to keep going, and it pushed me to do whatever I could do in order to, win the game. And I know my teammates feel the same way, too. We can't say good enough things about our coaching staff, and I'm just so happy because of the amount of work that my teammates have put in. It's all paying off, and I want them to know, like, to keep putting in that work, because we can continue to keep doing this. This can be, you know, what Vermont women's basketball is all about, and we're starting it today, and I'm just really, really, really happy for our team.
Going off what Emma said, I wouldn't have wanted to do this with any other team. I think everyone on the court and the coaches, like, included, like, are playing for each other, and I feel like I've never been a part of something like this, and it's completely different when you're out there and you're up by 3 points and there's 2 minutes left and you're, like, stressed, but, like, the team brings, like, calmness. We're, like, we're in it together, and that's what we did. We finished it together, so.
Well, defense is something that we work hard on each and every day in practice. And, you know, the coaches get on us and they're very, very detailed. But it's for reasons like today, because if you're not detailed, then maybe we don't win games like today. Because defense is what actually won that game for us, since offense wasn't working that well. And it's really hard and it's really gritty, but you got to want to do it. And I think every single person on our team has gotten more bought in each year that I've been here. The defense has just gotten so great. And our offense has been a little shaky at times this year, but the way that we've been able to pull through has been because of our defense.
Yeah, I agree with Emma. And also we have, like, the mindset that we're not leaving each other on islands. And so when you're playing out there thinking, like, oh, my teammate will have my back, then it's a lot easier to have confidence in defense and, you know, go hard, and it's okay if you get beat because you have a teammate there to help, so.
For Anna, how big was it to win the battle on the boards, especially with those 8 or 9 offensive rebounds you had?
I mean, it was big. I kind of go into the game thinking, like, do what I can control, and rebounding is all effort, so in this game, like, again, when shots weren't falling for me, I was like, well, I can get rebounds, and so I just boxed out, tried to get as many balls as I could.
I mean, I think offensively our team was getting really good looks. I just think that, you know, there's games where they don't go in. A lot of them are going in and out. Just wasn't going our way. Obviously, there's nerves there. It's a championship game. It's a packed house. And I know Albany and us, like, we've been looking forward to this game all season. So, yeah, there was definitely nerves there. But, I mean, I do think that we did what we could. And, you know, when you can't hit those shots, the fact that we were able to get offensive rebounds was huge. And we were able to get some of those extra offensive points because of that, even when our shots weren't going in.
I know it's great to have the home crowd support, but it was really loud in there. I know you all knew was having trouble hearing the calls. Was that an issue for you guys too, even with the intensity of the volume in there?
Yeah, definitely. But I mean, it's nice when our whole team's on the same page and we can echo command because we can hear each other on the court. So it helps a lot.
Anything else for Emma and Anna, guys?
What's going through your mind when they cut it to one late?
We got it. We're good. I mean, obviously, I was a little nervous. I'm not going to lie, obviously. But, you know, I have the utmost faith in my team. I had 4 fouls, and so I was going out and come back in, going back out. But I had so much faith in them. We prepared and practiced. We practiced these special situations all the time. So, yeah, I had no doubt that we were going to pull it out. No. No. No, not at all. To put it simply, no. We're going to celebrate until practice. So
tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
At 8 a.m.
Yeah. Yeah.
Turn it around.
Back in the lab.
Yep. Back in the lab.
Awesome. Well, you guys are good. Then we'll turn it over to questions for Coach. You guys can head on out.
Okay.
All right, guys.
Have fun.
There will be curfew.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Do I have any questions?
Whenever you guys are ready.
Yeah, I mean, what about the Albany defense is making it so tough for you guys to score, especially through the first 2 quarters?
No, I think Albany does an incredible job forcing you to have to play late in shot clock. And that's not something we've been very good at all season long. And I felt like when early actions in our offense didn't work, we kind of got panicked. And then we would settle. And they did an incredible job to take us out of rhythm. But I was expecting that. I thought we might have handled it with a little more poise. But some way we still found a way to score 38 points and win a championship. So we'll take it. Well, there's definitely been a shift in the culture here. Players are bought into doing it the right way and working hard. That nothing's going to be handed to you. You got to work really hard. And I felt like that in the summer. We had a group that was in the gym more than I've ever seen. And it starts there. And they truly loved each other. They were doing absolutely everything together. So there was just something special about the way they interacted and how they worked hard. And they fed off of being in the gym together. So as a coach, you're excited about that when you have players that love basketball and want to be in the gym. And that would do anything for themselves. So you knew through tough times, if they really cared about each other, they're going to find a way to do it together. And they're going to have each other's back. And then the season started, and a little rough. But there was a shift, and it seemed like we were so bought into whatever the coaches asked of them or they asked of each other. And so I'm like, okay, we're bought in. I think our offense needs to be better, but we're bought in defensively. And then Albany happened, and I was like, whoa, we got a real problem here. And then UMBC happened at home, and I'm like, ooh, that wasn't good either. We go to Bryant on the road. I'm like, we are not going to win a conference game. And in the locker room, I had 2 options, going in there as normal Kresge or losing my mind. And I felt like, you know what, I had to do something different. It wasn't working, and I got after him. I said, guys, this is your team. I will do anything for you, but it is your team, and you got to make this decision. Are you going to get tougher? Are you going to want it? Are you going to be locked in? Are you going to do everything we did when we knew we were playing well in non-conference? And they came out, and they found a way to win a game. And that was it. That's where I felt like the shift happened. Did I think that we'd be sitting here today in the summer? No. I mean, obviously, I always hope for that, and we plan for that, and we work hard talking about it, but could I say that? No. And when league play started, I was like, we're definitely not going to be sitting there. But they, every time we challenge them, they step up to the challenge. So I knew we had something special. I didn't know what that would turn into. So credit to them and being bought in and never giving up.
Anna had a big block late in the game. How was Scrubber influenced on the defensive end?
She was incredible. You know, just so locked in. And Anna's somebody that is a leader in so many ways, but not normally a vocal leader. But with the gym being the way it was, we needed her to be a vocal leader. She could see a lot in the way that they run their offense. She's behind it a lot. So we needed her to just be so locked in and focused. And I thought she was incredible in that sense. And then, like she shared, but going after rebounds. I mean, not too many times you see three players in double-digit rebounding and only one player with double-digit scoring who didn't get double-digit rebounding. I mean, I don't know if I've ever seen this kind of box score. But she's going to do anything she wanted or anything she could to help this team win. She's just tough as nails. Sometimes I'm telling her, you're getting killed. Like, stop being that tough. Like, take one. Like, you're getting killed. But thankfully, Anna is who she is, and she was just a monster for us defensively and rebounding. I was really proud of her.
Coach, at points this year, I know you've gotten on them for rebounding. We talked about it already, but how did that sway the game?
Definitely in the last, I would say, 5-6 games, his team has bought in. To be honest, I'm not really sure what shifted. We've talked about it. We showed them. We're coaching them about it. But they must have, one night in the dorms, talked through and said, we're going to rebound for Coach because she might kill us. But it's just been something that has changed in them. And we talked a lot about it. If we wanted to win this game, the last two times we played Albany, we did not win the boards. And I felt like that was going to be one of the biggest keys, is we had to win the boards. And, Bella's always done it. But I'm just really proud of them, that it was that hustle stuff that early on, I'm not sure I would say that was what Vermont was doing well. And we found a way to do it late when everybody's exhausted, the game's on the line, and they found a way to muscle in and get another stop or another rebound offensively. I don't know what shifted, but it's a good thing.
Hey, Coach, I asked them what they were going to do. What about you? Like, how are you going to enjoy this? Because this is, I don't know the history. I'm assuming it's your first time going to the big dance, right? That's like a coach.
Absolutely.
So how are you going to enjoy this? What's the next step?
This is such a lame answer. I would love to go to sleep. No, I'm very fortunate to have family in town and good friends, and my head coach when I was a player, and then my mentor in the business is here, and a lot of good friends in town that have supported us in so many ways. So we're going to go probably sit and watch some basketball and soak it all up that we get to play another game, and it's in the big dance, and we're really excited. But I'm going to enjoy it tonight with friends and family, and then I'm going to sleep.
Anything else for Coach Gass?
Coach, we've seen this team win so many different ways. What does it say about this group?
They don't give up. They want it. It's sometimes pretty, sometimes not. But they wanted it so bad, and they believed in themselves. I really am proud of them. I didn't think we'd be this kind of defensive-stopping team to start. Being a defensive-minded coach, I'm very nitpicky, as they say, and I felt like there's no way we'd be able to do things like this. So they proved me wrong once again, and I'm really proud of them for proving me wrong.